Exactly. But they decided to celebrate their victories. And in celebrating their victories, they used liqueurs and of different types to celebrate those victories. And what they did was they mixed them all together and they called it artillery punch. Now, I will tell you right now, if you've never had this before and this is your first time, we are not responsible for you after your first cup. If something happens to you on the first cup, we'll give you CPR or whatever, okay? But after that, you're on your own.
You're on your own, baby.
Because I ain't going to give CPR when someone's vomiting or something like that.
Just roll them to the side.
Roll you over in the ditch and cover you up, okay? It's never, that's never happened, right? I don't think anybody's ever thrown that.
I don't know about all that.
I think everybody has. All right, we're gonna start.
Go ahead.
For our first charge. The first charge is Napoleon Brandy. Since all artillery punch included brandy and red wine. Okay, so everything they ever made in artillery punch.
That's charge.
Would do that. All right, so what we need is what we got here.
Need some volunteers.
Need two volunteers.
I volunteer.
Okay, come on. Two volunteers, come on. Come on.
I volunteer. They never poured it yet.
You going,
I got
Kevin?
The brandy.
Yep.
They both are.
Barb.
I got something.
You
got
to hold the bag.
Can
we need
take a
some red wine,
too. Oh, it has a boy call. Can I take a swig before?
Go for it.
Like this? I'll take the last swig. I want to spread the germ.
That's the first charge, too. Okay, y'all don't go nowhere. You gotta pour in some red wine.
Okay.
Here you go.
Low.
Empty.
Ice is cracking.
That ice is saying, what are you doing to me?
Yeah. Don't
it's melting.
I'm going to do it back to you.
Yeah. And then red wine.
All right. Red wine.
Next.
It's on the same thing. Red wine.
Red wine. Red wine. Red wine.
Red wine.
Red wine.
Billy.
Base charge.
First charge. Napoleon Brandy and Brandy and red wine.
Well, skip that. We'll get to that later.
Okay. We'll do it later. All right. The second charge is Everclear, representing our clear victory.
I'm not doing that one.
In the Mexican War.
You can do it.
So we need a volunteer. Volunteer.
Oh, volunteer.
I do it.
Come on.
I was like, no.
The whole thing?
The whole, yes, ma'am.
Is that another volunteer?
It won't hurt you.
It only burns.
I don't burn a little bit.
That's what she said.
Yeah. It kills what ails you.
It can take the rust off you.
Okay. Yes, y'all will.
Let me do something now. This is part of the ceremony, too.
You got to stir it.
It's time to stir it. Just to let you know, this is not just an ordinary saber. This is an original. So every time we do artillery punch, we use an original saber. Yes, sir.
Can I stir?
You want to do it?
I sure do. Right. I've never done it before. I've drunk it plenty of times. I've never done it before.
Off in the cherry?
Yep. I want to. Is Burgundy, representing the bloodshed on both sides of the war between the states. Need a volunteer.
Volunteers.
Volunteer.
Get it in there.
Come on.
Yes.
Come on.
There's two bottles.
Two bottles of everything.
No, you don't get a sample of it. You gotta pour it all in there, man. Pour it all in there.
Pour it in there.
Pour it in there.
Good stir. We need another good stir. John?
I'll check. I'll switch.
Charge is grenadine syrup because after the war the artillery reorganized into a non-military organization. Need a volunteer.
Volunteer?
Yeah, with it.
Oh.
I go a second time.
Here.
You ready? Pouring. Empty?
Right.
Or Sunday.
Yeah. Next year.
I'll pick it up.
The fifth charge is rum, representing our service during the Spanish-American War, where the unit created the Cuba Libre, now known as the Rum and Coke. I know we got some volunteers for that.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Salute. And then. Yep.
And the stuff will clean your cup out.
Got it. Stir.
Thank you, sir.
There you go. I hope. That's
all I like to fly. The sixth charge is French wine to honor our French artillery brother and our skilled red legs during World War I.
Volunteers?
Volunteers!
Got a pour.
Volunteers!
Just got a pour.
Come on, just pour a bottle of wine.
One volunteer.
Got one, there's two bottles.
Hey, go around that side.
They got one over there.
We'll get you
no,
next one.
I'm just thinking the cooking. Yeah, you want to drink it, you know?
Patience, grasshopper.
And clean your cup out.
I want to learn.
I guarantee that it'll make the cup instant shine.
Gratification.
The seventh charge is Pat O'Brien's Hurricane Mix, representing our state mission, past, present, and future.
I'll switch with you.
Hold on, you got to pop the
Waltzing lately?
Yeah, I got that one.
I already got one. You ready?
Go ahead.
Corn.
You got it here, baby. Come on. No, because I got to do some of that.
Of course you read it. You don't know. I'm from Florida. I'm born in Florida.
No, don't kill him. He's another screw on me.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Oh, start. I switch again.
I'm make our own up and just go to
the what they doing? They, like they ain't poured it all in.
We'll get strawberry daiquiris.
Come on up here. We need volunteers to pour.
Oh, yeah, well, go right
to pour.
To pour. Go around that way.
The eighth charge.
Charge 8, white bag.
Is wines from Italy, France, and Germany representing our service during World War II.
Enzio.
That's me right there. We got 3 rounds on that.
Go ahead.
He's Italian.
Sicilian, yep. Not Italian.
Anybody else?
Yeah. Come on.
Need one more. One.
Step forward.
What you got?
That one? Go ahead. That's what we need all at one time. Shake it up. Woo. Shake it up.
Got one more.
Oh, that's all wine.
Oh, hell yeah.
Man, they're good.
That's all wine.
And then some.
You're waiting. There's about a pound of brown sugar in it.
The ninth charge is Bordeaux wine, honoring February 10th, 1971. When the artillery was authorized its official title to be the traditional title of the Washington Artillery. John, I think since you were a member of the Washington Artillery Active Battalion, you have the honor.
Switch. Both of them?
Yeah, both of them.
You staying?
Both of them.
We're going to be hearing him with me.
Okay. Hold that.
I got it.
From now on, we have somebody else handling the ceremonies. Tom, Lieutenant Tom Wolf.
Okay. Now we're going to honor the infantry.
The Queen of Battle?
Mm-hmm.
The Queen of Battle?
Get a donation here from one. He's an infantryman and an artilleryman.
I'm going to get you number.
So he's going to sacrifice a piece of clothing here for us to
honor. Let me get my stuff real quick.
All right. Let me give it.
Oh, give it a stir. Yeah. Give it a stir.
Give it a quick stir. Yeah.
You got an extra pair of socks?
I'm gonna have to take this back after.
You want me a room?
Okay, well.
Well, you've been hit some Thursday, huh?
Let's see how. Oh, yeah. Oh, good.
Hit some Thursday.
The Queen of Battle.
That's from the infantry. That's from all the thousands of miles that they marched.
Woo!
That's the honor of the sock.
That's off of his sock.
I don't know what the cabbage is.
Hey, Robert.
Yes,
sir. It's going to be as good as Aunt Dee's kerosene pickles.
I hope that didn't come off of William's foot.
You can substitute this for kerosene by the time we're done.
I hope you didn't come off of William's foot.
Be so
Robert.
Shiny. Oh, it did.
Did it? Are you shitting me?
All right, next we're going to honor the
I gotta get
horses
clean
to pull the artillery for us with the horseshoe.
Horses and the mules.
The most horses and the mules.
Did all the hard work, the poor babies.
Hope that ain't a lead horseshoe.
Okay.
Okay, now we got a couple of charges put in here. Let's wait on that. Now we're going to honor the ladies. So, need some ladies.
This is two ladies.
Ladies?
Oh, those are ladies.
Ladies in the crowd.
Step up, baby. Come on.
Hi,
Porky, you do it. We're going to drink.
Got one more. Another lady. Come on, step up.
Ooh. I want you to save me that bottle.
Hey,
too.
Billy.
Yeah, okay, it's going to be popped off. Another lady.
Where's the cork at?
Another lady.
There we go.
I'm
Lady Hazel.
You got a pocket, girl.
Lady Hazel.
Y'all keep pouring stuff out, I'm going to go take
it. Like the Brer Rich projects.
I hope the bottom doesn't fall out of it before we get done.
It ain't yet.
Watch.
All right, go get some acorn.
Don't pop off.
In that.
Don't pop off.
It does. Yeah, it
does. Yeah, no, yeah.
Sure, it didn't pop off. Don't pop off. Her.
No, no shit.
Oh, no!
No.
Oh,
shit!
Shoot it. Woman with a weapon.
Who the hell's that?
Oh, I don't want to hold my tent.
Oh, shit.
Come off.
And that's when the pork hit the lantern.
Stick that thing out here. I'll take care of it.
And the flaming thumb off. And the flaming
thumb.
There you go. Hey, you got a little head on it.
Yeah.
Like a beer.
Never had it. They never did it here last time.
Boy.
Must be anniversary day.
Are they
coming
from
up there? Oh, don't worry. I got plenty of
that. Everybody said we're coming later.
They didn't do anything.
Okay. Where you at?
But she missed
all of it. We need an article of clothing from the ladies.
Who?
That's for the ladies helping the war machine, sewing clothes, uniforms, making ammunition for the men in the fight. So that's to honor them, her stocking.
All right, Brian, come here.
Oh Lord.
Okay, here we go. We got a charge. We got an artillery. We got a charge up here now. We got some grape shot.
So do I get a badge after this?
No, you didn't get a badge, all right.
I'll get a sword up my ass.
Coastal Kev, come here. All right, we also have some canister.
Yeah, canister.
All right,
represented by these cherries.
Popping.
Are these cherries?
It's cherry canister.
Yeah, canister. Canister.
Look, shake it.
Shake it.
There you go. All right, good job. All right, let's see. We need a light.
What else we got in our box down there?
All right, for the peace and resistance.
Uh-huh.
We got to have a charge. We got to have some powder.
Oh shit.
Low.
So you guys that were counting on thinking on getting something tonight, Salt Peter's gonna put the hurt on you.
Head down.
Darling, I'm out.
Are you serious?
Yeah. It's not the real thing, don't worry. Hey, it's actually Oreo cookies ground up.
Live rounds.
That was the piece of resistance. Now, here comes the interesting part. The interesting part is, who here in this group of fine people is the most expendable person that we think?
Mason.
The most expendable.
Yep, him.
You hear what they're saying, right?
Sort of, but I'm not good with words.
Here's what you got to do. When you dip your cup, by honoring the troops, you say load. So that's what you do.
Load.
Say it, Mason.
Load.
Or just dip powder.
Dip your cup.
Dip cup in there.
Dip your cup in there.
Load.
Load.
Take a hit.
All right, let's see what happens.
Is he dead?
He's still alive.
Damn, still with us. Whoa! Artillery fire! Ladies, make your way forward, ladies. Ladies, if you don't hurry up.
I want to get my first. I'll get the first cup.
Ladies, come on.
Go ahead.
Low.
There you go.
Short round.
Ladies.
Low.
We're going to initiate two bangers tonight with this.
Hey, Zo.
Go ahead.
Low.
That's all right. They call me Glenn anyway.
Gentlemen, step forward.
How about a salute?
Too slow.
Low.
Tastes like
water.
It's good.
Load!
Load!
Load! Load!
Load!
Load!
Watch you small
load.
Charge 8!
Whoa!
Load.
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 Load!
Hold off on drinking a little bit now. Hold off on drinking just a little bit.
Let's at least get every, one time.
We gotta get everybody loaded.
Yeah,
I'm right.
Not yet.
I mean the glasses.
Oh, okay.
We got my company! We're gonna make some toasts.
Load!
All right. Anybody out?
Yeah. First toast.
Mm-hmm. Hold on.
Whoa. Look out.
And rip there,
Kevin. Whoa!
Jake! He don't even know.
First toast goes to our great hosts, the 5th Company Washington Artillery.
Hey!
Damn. That stuff's so good, I might be able to do somebody some good.
Is that fine grade powder?
It was triple L.
I could really taste the sock.
Second toast.
I just want to point out, if GoEx had gone out of business, we couldn't have done that. Just saying.
Second toast.
Several names I'll put in here. Jeff Davis, Robert E. Lee, the Confederacy.
Yay!
God save the South. God save his country, man.
Y'all take your turns. Who wants to toast something?
Stonewall Jackson. Hey.
How about?
To the guns.
You
got to go out. Fuck the Democrats. Commie rats.
4th Company Washington Artillery.
4th Company.
Wolfpack.
Thank you. Wolfpack.
Tigers first.
Tigers first.
To Governor Thomas Overton Moore of Louisiana.
About the Lieutenant Governor running for office coming up.
Billy?
What's his name?
Landry.
His great grandfather's monument.
Mouton.
Talking about Gilroy.
He's Lieutenant Governor. Billy Nungess is Lieutenant Governor.
Yeah, he's running for Lieutenant Governor.
That toast is too long.
He's going to help us out.
God bless Dixie.
And the South will rise again, baby.
Hell and all hell.
Go ahead.
Hell and all hell.
Toast?
Hey, I got one.
Toast?
Cold beer.
Long matters lines.
We got a toast right here.
I want to say fuck both of the 2 governors.
To all the Southern ladies. Yes.
And the hell with the governor and the lieutenant governor.
I'm going to
take care of all the 4
And wear makeup. And dress.
Yeah. Like Fort Pike.
Yeah. True.
Did you give a toast?
Lieutenant, I'm going out.
Come
lieutenant.
Up here and give a toast.
I ain't got no.
Yes, you do. Come on, you got something. Your mom, your dad, the South, God,
grandparents,
Jesus,
your Confederate ancestors.
To the man that fought for this country.
Hey!
Past and present.
To all our members that have gone before us.
Hey!
Here.
Shalom. To Ken Wheeler that is not here.
By the time we finish toasting, we're going to be shit-faced.
Yeah, man. Damn, I tell you what.
It's smoother than the 141 makes.
141, Washington Artillery, Active Battalion.
Active Battalion, here.
For those that don't know, the Washington Artillery ended up being a big unit, and they split them up in World War II. Listen to me slur my words on it. They made another unit. It was called the 773rd Tank Destroyer Battalion. And one of the guys that was in our unit, Frank Spees Jr., his daddy was the commander of that unit. They hit D-Day plus 3, and they went all the way to Czechoslovakia. They destroyed 1,100 German armored vehicles on the way. They took 16,000 prisoners along the way. And he was, if his daddy was like his son, God bless his soul, and to them,
here,
I raise my
here.
I tell you what,
excellent.
That's some good shit.
Hey, your mama's calling you.
Yeah.
To her mama.
Right.
Hey.
Mama. My right-hand person. Hey, Mom.
No, we're not drinking.
Let me call you back. I got a sock to suck on right here.
I have to tell her what I'm doing.
I got toast. Here's to the old reenactors that gone before us.
Yes.
Like Mike Harper and all the rest of them.
Here.
Ron Strabos. John Bang.
I got one.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah.
Robert. To my sock.
Yes.
All right, to his sock. By the way, can I have it back? My feet are cold.
Take it out of there and suck on it.
That's right.
All right. Put it in your cup. That's what I did.
My dad died. I should soak.
You want it?
Sing somewhere. My dad and John Flynn are arguing about work.
Yeah. You know, put the matching pair out.
You know, Mike Harper.
What's that?
Put the other one in there and have a matching pair.
Okay.
If y'all don't mind, I have a toast.
Is it toast?
Toast.
Okay. This is to my dad. He's passed. Dad was in World War II, Korea, and Vietnam. He was in Leghorn, Italy. They ended up moving him up on the Po River, and he actually fired the first shots against communism against the Yugoslavians. They wanted war reparations from Italy, and he was on the border there fighting the Yugoslavians. He got out in 47, went back in 49, and he was in Korea when hostilities broke out in 1950 on July 4th weekend. And he went in with 152 artillerymen and 450 infantry. That was about 540 men against 20,000 North Koreans. They lost half their unit in the first battle. Dad was missing in action twice. 3 days the first time, 13 days the second. He earned 2 Bronze Stars. One with cluster, 2 unit citations. I could go on and on about what the medals he has. But he made it out, bless his soul, and before he got out, they sent him to Vietnam. They put him in the Mekong Delta. He was the first sergeant at 3 fire bases. They were drug ridden. They were letting the enemy walk in the camps freely, bring in the drugs, messing our soldiers up, and he put a stop to it. He closed the gates. No Vietnamese person was allowed inside unless they were military. He stopped the drugs. He stopped the alcohol drinking and all. And he only lost 1 young man while he was there. He was there for 6 months, and his tour, not his tour of duty, but his time was up. And he left, and he came home in 67, and he said, 21 years is enough. So I want to say to my dad and to the rest of you who have your dads that fought. I know Glenn's daddy was in World War II. He went through France and into Germany.
Sixth Armor,
okay? To all those guys.
Here.
Yeah.
To the veterans.
The veterans.
That's right.
I'll tell you what, that's some good damn shit. It's getting gooder as it goes.
Hell, I have a great uncle named CB.
In the CBs?
Mm-hmm. Boy, yeah. He was on one of them islands. Every time them Japanese pop out damn hole and start shooting them, he'd take a bulldog and just run them over and cut the heads off. Cut the heads off, bury them at the same time.
Bury them in the sand.
Showed him.
Hey, to save the funeral service.
Yeah. Had one in CBs, one in the Air Force, and one in
I don't think they believed in a burial service anyway. I think they cremated their soul.
They showed him.
So we interrupted their ritual way to heaven.
Yeah.
Or wherever they were going.
Well, he chopped the heads off, so.
Yeah. They couldn't see where they were going.
That damn show couldn't.
My great-grandfather and, well, both my great-grandfathers were in World War II. Uh-huh. Their dads were in World War I.
Wow.
My grandfather was in Vietnam. My uncle was in Desert Storm. My cousin was in Iraq. My other cousin was in Vietnam as a corpsman. It's been a hell of a ride. I was supposed to be seventh generation, but I had a fucked up ankle.
God bless them.
Glad you came over.
All right. And that concludes our artillery punch ceremony.
All right.
So drink.
And be married. And pass out somewhere.